Welcome to a new season of Movie Time. It's good to be back for our first episode of the school year. In this episode, we will be spotlighting three classic and three contemporary art house films. An art house film, or simply an art film, is a typically independently made film aimed at a specific audience rather than a mass market audience. Art films can include symbolic or philosophical material and can also be experimental in nature. The six films we will be talking about today have had great impact on the world of art house cinema. We will be going in chronological order of the release of the films. Kicking off today's episode is the François Truffaut classic, The 400 Blows, released in 1959. The film tells the story of a young, neglected boy who goes into a life of crime. The film was nominated for a Best Original Screenplay Oscar and is considered to be one of the most important films in movie history, as it helped start the French New Wave film movement and redefined how movies were made by instituting new techniques used during the French New Wave. We also talked about this when we covered Jean-Luc Godard's classic Breathless in a previous episode. Check out The 400 Blows. Fantastic film. Next up is a film from Italian filmmaker Federico Fellini. The film, which made Fellini a world-renowned director, revolves around a paparazzo journalist living in Rome. It helped put Italian cinema on the world map, and it also coined the term paparazzi. Here's the classic La Dolce Vita, first released in 1960.
Sì, Silvia. Vengo anch'io. Ma sì, ha ragione lei, sto sbagliando tutto. Stiamo sbagliando tutto. Sì. Sì, ma chi sei?
Classic. Now here's a film from acclaimed director Andrei Tarkovsky. Tarkovsky is recognized as a very philosophical and psychological filmmaker, and our next film really shows that. Recently, a restored version of his film Stalker was released in theaters. The film is highly unusual and really makes you think. Revolving around a man who leads a couple of men through an area called the Zone in search of a room that grants wishes, 1979 Stalker is visually stimulating. Check out a scene.
И вот произошло великое землетрясение, и солнце стало мрачно, как власеница, и луна сделалась, как кровь, и звезды небесные пали на землю, как смоковница, потрясаемая сильным ветром, роняет незрелые смоквы свои, и небо скрылось, свившись, как свиток, и всякая гора, и остров двинулись с мест своих.
Fascinating. Now we move on to contemporary or modern art house cinema, which started in the late 1980s and early 1990s forward. First up, we have Darren Aronofsky's masterpiece of addiction and mental illness, Requiem for a Dream. Following the relationships between four people and their struggle with drug addiction, Requiem, released in 2000, is brutal and hard to watch, but is very important and well done. If you can stomach it, you should absolutely see it. Have a look.
Hello?
Mariana.
Yuri?
Mariana, I've been thinking about you so much. Are you okay?
When are you coming home?
Soon.
When?
Soon. You holding out, right?
Harry? Can you come today? Yeah.
One of the most horrifying films I've ever seen. Now here's a clip from a 2001 film that many critics consider to be one of the best of the 21st century. David Lynch's Mulholland Drive follows an amnesiac and a Hollywood dreamer on a journey around Los Angeles after a car accident. Bizarre and chilling, like most of Lynch's work, this film's imagery is haunting and thought-provoking. Let's check it out.
Yes? May I help you?
Someone is in trouble. Who are you? What are you doing in Ruth's apartment?
She's letting me stay here. I'm her niece. My name's Betty.
No, it's not. That's not what she said. Someone is in trouble. Something bad is happening.
I'm sorry, but I don't know who you are, and...
Louise, what are you doing, Louise?
Speaking of a journey, let's go to Tokyo. Sofia Coppola's Lost in Translation follows a movie star and a young woman's evolving platonic relationship after they meet one night in Tokyo. The 2003 film was nominated for Best Picture at the Oscars and is visually beautiful and philosophical. Here's a look.
So what are you doing here?
Couple of things. Taking a break from my wife, forgetting my son's birthday, and getting paid $2 million to endorse a whiskey when I could be doing a play somewhere.
Oh.
But the good news is the whiskey works. What are you doing?
My husband's a photographer, so he's here working, and wasn't doing anything, so I came along, and we have some friends that live here.
Well, I hope you've enjoyed our journey into the world of art house films. Next episode, just in time for Halloween, we will spotlight ghost and supernatural films. Until then, this is the end, my friends.